Welcome back to Instables again, going over our daily update on our intraday swing and long perspective here again after Powell speaking a couple days ago, mentioning that we need an increase in unemployment, now sitting on a pullback after our initial jobless claims coming out this morning, showing a stronger jobs report than expected. So again, an increase in jobs rather than an increase in unemployment that, again, Jerome Powell did mention that we do need for that continuation on higher. We also had a false breakout prior. Again, when we had CPI, we had a spike. But the following day here with Powell speaking, again, he mentioned that unemployment wasn't exactly where we did need. Now sitting on a pullback with a similar narrative, what are we looking for as our 20-day is crossing above our 50? Looking for that shift from bearish into bullish momentum. Again, jumping above the upper end of our channel here that we have been getting rejections from. Are we going to continue on higher here? I'm going to go over exactly what we're looking for here. Hit the like button if you enjoy. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And if you are a day trader, if you're looking for pre-market news before market open, looking for those major volatile breakouts that you want to be watching throughout the day, go to Instables.com in the description below. And for only $15 a month, you will never miss a breakout alert today again. Let's jump into this one. So jumping into the spy with you guys, looking at our intraday perspective off the bat here, looking at our daily candle structure, as you guys can see here, sitting on an engulfing candle. Again, our current day's body covering our prior day's body to the downside, showing us an engulfing candle to the downside. So we are cautious, playing to the upside intraday. We are looking for that possible bullish candle structure. Again, yesterday's body candle closing within our prior day's body, consolidating, looking for that possible major move higher or possible major move lower here, as we were looking at the hourly chart again, as you guys can see, sitting on our symmetric triangle here that we were tracking. And as you guys can see today, getting a rejection to the upside, just as we were testing. As you guys can see, we were testing our 20 as we were also testing the upper end of our symmetric triangle here. So again, we did have our doji candle coming out. We followed through, dropping below here and then dropping below our 50, continuing on down here, now dropping below that symmetric triangle, making sure that we are cautious again to the upside, looking for that possible shift from bearish into bullish momentum. Four swings is what we're looking for here. Again, we do have an engulfing candle, which typically does show that we do follow through on a continuation on lower, however, with a possible support. And also, as we do have an engulfing candle, not pushing against the resistance, as you guys can see, again, if we were having an engulfing candle at a possible resistance that we had prior, that would show a lot more strength to the downside, more room to run to the downside. But we are still sitting on a pullback, a stronger pullback after our symmetric triangle that we did have on the hourly chart, but very much looking to see if we can possibly get a bullish candle set up here. Maybe we get a possible doji candle. Maybe we possibly test our 20 and then possibly get that possible morning star like we had prior on our 20 day here as we were curling up. So again, that is a morning star possible setup if we are going to shift from bearish into bullish momentum. But again, at this point in time, intraday, looking to see if we do hold our 20 for that possible short-term bounce. But again, if we are going to continue on lower, we want to see if we do close here on the daily. Again, possibly going into tomorrow below our 20. Let's say tomorrow we do have our 20 that continues to curl here, and then we do close again within our 20-day moving average. That could be that possible follow through and assumption that we would test our 50 as we are curling up here. So again, that would be that bearish case scenario if we were looking for that intraday. But again, looking for that major shift in momentum, in my opinion, would be case. So if we were going to be heavy to the downside, I would want to see, again, a possible continuation on lower here and then a possible retest on our 20-day and then our 20-day curling back over here to cross down below our 50. That would be, again, that confirmation that we would be looking for on that continuation on lower. That would be a stronger play to the downside. So in my opinion, very much looking to see if we will possibly turn back around here again. We are sitting on a pullback, a stronger pullback that could continue on down to our 50-day moving average for all we know at this point in time. But going into tomorrow, how we close, if we close on a doji candle again as we are testing our 20-day moving average, or if we close below our 20-day, will be the watch, and very much on watch going into next week on exactly how we close tomorrow's candle, in my opinion. Now looking at the weekly chart again, we have been talking about for the last couple weeks how we did close above the up and over channel on our weekly chart. We did continue on higher, now sitting on a possible rejection candle that can close going into tomorrow, which also can be an inside bar candle that also is a possible inverted hammer here that can close going into tomorrow. So again, that would be a rejection candle to the upside for that possible retest. Again, assuming if we do continue on higher, We would want that swing momentum to come with us here with our 20-week moving average crossing above our 50-week moving average. And again, if we are overall bullish, then we would want, again, that retest sooner than later, in my opinion, so that way we get more confirmation sooner than later. So again, that's what we're looking for from a swing perspective. Again, we have been talking about how we need confirmation on our weekly chart. If we are going to continue on higher here, again, a nice continuation and a nice break above the up end of our channel here. But we are looking for confirmation, looking for our 20-week moving average crossing above and closing above our 50-week moving average going to next week will be key. And then getting that bullish candle structure again to continue on higher as we do respect our 20-week moving average will be the watch going into next week. So again, keep that in mind. If we want to continue on higher, assuming that we do need to retest our 20-week moving average since we are still below our 50-week moving average, will be the narrative and what we're looking for. And again, looking at the monthly chart, again, we have been talking about this, guys, how the monthly chart really does show us a lot about our intraday and swing momentum. Again, as we have been talking about, as we did test our 20-month moving average, we are now sitting on an inverted hammer here. And again, a rejection candle currently that could close a lot stronger or possibly can continue on with this rejection candle if we were going to possibly have that major bearish case scenario. And again, with CPI coming out on Tuesday next week, that will be the bigger watch on how we close this month's candle. Again, if we go into CPI, we possibly hold above the up end of our channel here, even if we have a bad CPI. Again, if we have a possible increase in inflation, again, we have our deflationary momentum that we have been getting, guys. We've been having a very nice deflationary momentum narrative lately, but we very much do have possible increases in inflation that Powell seems to be possibly worried about. And leading into next Tuesday, in my opinion, today we very much did have a cool down because we are leading to next week's CPI, and the markets do need to make sure they are being cautious and making sure that we do price in an increase in inflation if it happens to happen. So again, we did have a pullback here. We were testing our prior sell-off point again here, and now we are looking to see if we will get a possible major decrease in CPI to follow through with that possible narrative on Powell, again, giving us softer landing. But if we get an increase in rates, that gives us a possible no landing zone, which again could make markets sell off. So again, going into next week with CPI, we'll see exactly what it comes out as. If we get a decrease in CPI or a higher CPI, that will give us the overall narrative here if we continue on higher, or if we are going to continue on with this momentum above the up end of our channel. Again, that will be what we're looking for. Again, to recap on our intraday momentum, again, sitting on an engulfing candle, although not on a resistance. So again, this isn't exactly a major sell-off engulfing candle to the downside at all. This is very much testing our 20-day moving average and very much possibly shifting from bearish into bullish momentum still. So again, we'll see exactly what tomorrow's candle closes as. If we do close with that doji candle, possibly open and close higher going into next week on Monday and Tuesday, and we continue on with that possible, again, that would still be a possible Morningstar setup. So again, we will see exactly what happens. Now again, with that said, if you are a day trader, if you are looking for pre-market news that you want to be watching, very volatile breakouts that we mentioned in the Instables room, any breakout that is worth looking at throughout the day, go to instables.com in the description below. And for only $15 a month, join us and over 300 members in the Instables room, and you will be watching the best pre-market news that you want to be watching. Again, go to instables.com in the description below, and you will never miss a breakout alert today. Again, all of you Instables, again, continue to take what the market gives us. Pretty choppy today, again, as we did sit on this pullback. And in my opinion, very much a follow-through as we are leading to next week's CPI. We very much do need to make sure that we do possibly price in a major sell-off that could come if we get an increase in CPI, of course. And a lot of Feds seem to be worried about a possible increase in CPI, and that increase in CPI would simply give us and prolong us for a possible longer and less likely soft landing to come. So again, we need to make sure we keep that in mind, that we are very much pricing and leading into CPI next week, and we are sitting on a pullback. So again, we'll see exactly what happens. And again, if you guys do like this video, it does help the channel grow, and I do appreciate it very much. And again, God bless you all, and I'll see you guys in pre-market.